heart is a million. 7:02 in the morning, December 21st. Yes, you heard that right. December 21st. Roy and Jimmy in the morning. My name is Roy Brewster, and this is
Earth. I am Jimmy Shaw. Good morning, everybody. Like Roy said, the Monday before Christmas, 21st already of a year 2020 coming to a close.
Some bitch.
Some of a bitch. Good morning, Roy Brewster.
Well, good morning, Jimmy Shaw. It's been a long time.
We had our annual Christmas play last night, and to say that it didn't meet the criteria.
Just like all the rest of them.
Fucking crushed it. We had a good time last night with that. And I want to thank everybody for joining in, tuning in to that. And what's the list of people there? We had the Claudia Cortez, Richard Weiss, our own Donna Main, the Harbottles, Kathy, Steve, and Emma.
Yep.
The debut of Robin Williams, Don Holden Brewster, Ariana Casino, and then we had Sean Williams. Is that it?
Nope.
Oh no. Stephanie. Yep. Rin Yolson.
Yep.
And the lovely Amy O'Neill, who I thought was adorable.
Oh my God, she was a great.
Adorable as Ruby Sue.
Ruby Sue, yeah.
So if you missed it and you dare try, the video is on our YouTube page. YouTube.com/Roy and Jimmy, and it'll be up as a podcast later this week, along with everything else.
All of it's going to be all of it, son.
We said all of it, son. I'm signing into the old phone bank here, Roy.
The phone bank?
Well, you know, our phones.
Oh, that. Oh, yeah.
The thing we don't use anymore. If anyone dares, it's 909-509-4063.
I remembered it that time.
And that is the Roy and Jimmy hotline right there.
Yeah, it is. Hey, so I got a question.
Actually, it's the cold line.
And this is for the listeners out there as much as for Roy.
Yes.
So when does it go live on YouTube?
What are you talking about?
What we did last night, yeah.
I'm not sure. Sometimes I think it's within a half hour.
Because it's not there.
It's not there. Did we get blocked?
I don't know.
Did you block it, Roy?
No.
Roy, be honest.
Last one there is 5 days ago.
Let's see here. Let's go.
And I wondered that because I was looking for another one the other day and it wasn't there.
Yeah, it's kind of weird. You got to go to the video. The way they have it.
You go to home and then not home. You got to go to videos.
Yeah, then you go to videos.
Right. And then sort. It's just watch you go. Sort by newest if you want to do it that way to make sure it's in there.
Right.
Yeah, it's not there. Last one's 15th and then today.
Well, it's a processing away.
Ah,
you know them YouTubers. Look at that. We have my mom in the house. Good morning, Mom. Drew Yerkish. Good morning, Drew, and the ever popular and always bubbly Art Emery. Good morning, guys.
Art.
Art is I drive by an Arby's and I just start giggling now.
Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Very festive sweater you have going on, Roy.
Yeah. I just went a little cool t-shirt action. I got another special one for you tomorrow.
Ooh.
You know, being Christmas week and all.
Got a theme going on, do you?
I'm just going to be a little bit of elf today.
You little elfy, Roy.
Yeah. What happened was, the real reason is, but this is why I really did it, but I didn't, but I really did it for the show, but it wasn't something else. But just so you know, it was really this.
No laundry?
No.
Swim trunks for underwear?
No. You saw the Christmas sweater I wore last night.
Yes, very exciting.
Which you may not know wasn't a Christmas sweater. I just had on a tie and a fluffy jacket.
Well, that's pretty wrinkly for being a shirt, right?
That was all me right there in the middle. That was all me right there.
You were quite bumpy, I must say.
Yeah. So, we were going to go to a Christmas sweater party that got canceled.
Right.
Because, you know, everything going on. So I didn't get to wear it. Well, before I bought it, I was in a pinch. So I said, I bought these two shirts. One like this and the one I'll surprise everyone tomorrow. See, good shirt. So I'll wear this one. So now I have two of these shirts that I have for no reason. So this is going to be the Monday and Tuesday attire to bring us into the festive mood, just like you are, Jimmy. I see festivity behind you with the little trees and the decorations, and I see a Santa Claus over here over your shoulder.
Behind me is a Noel.
I see him.
Yeah, I kept everything. Well, we did the show last night, and I set it up here in my living room, which is always a joy. And instead of going through all that hassle of moving it back out to the home office in the garage there, I said, you know, let's just leave it be. We'll get back to the true Jimmy tomorrow morning.
Leave it be.
Leave it be.
Leave the Christmas decos. Leave it be.
So see? We have a guest this morning, at 8 o'clock hour, actress Adriana Delgado.
Delgado
will be joining us. She's an actress, among other things, and done movies, videos, films. So she'll be joining us in the 8 o'clock hour. If you have any questions for her, hit her right here up on the YouTube and Facebook chat.
On the chat, that's where we can get you on the chat. I got a lot today. A lot of energy left over.
Do you?
Yeah.
And there's a lovely Dawn. We gave you a little heads. Gave you a little shout out, baby. Good, great debut. Your actress mode.
Actress mode.
And really appreciate Sean Williams letting you do your lines unabated.
Yeah, that's the nicest shot.
That's always a nice thing.
Yeah, you know what it was. He put on that Cousin Eddie hat last night.
Yeah.
And
the motorhome motif.
Yeah, it made him in the giving mood.
It did. It actually did put him in the mood.
Yeah. Yeah, that was good. I got to tell you, I was worried
about.
I was worried about Clark's rants last night that I'd be able to pull them off. And
is that why you and Don were in separate rooms? So the spit flying.
Oh,
arms flailing.
Maybe.
Didn't take an eye out or anything.
Maybe. But the rants worked.
Fun with them. the big rant that he's known for was proud of it. You weren't winded at the end.
Yeah.
You weren't.
Yeah.
That's all I can do. That's all I can do.
Right.
Shot your wad. You're good.
Yeah. That was. Yeah. Holy hell. Where's the title?
Hallelujah. Yeah. Holy shit. Where's the title? Yeah. Essence. You had essence on that line.
That was fun. And I gotta tell you, I gotta tell you, inside joke. It's really, inside jokes are great for people listening.
Oh yeah.
They're the best. So
at some point, that's why you have to keep listening.
Right.
So at some point you got the history.
Yeah.
The backstory.
We'll probably never tell you.
And we'll never tell you, but you're going to go, that darn essence.
You know what's funny is what am I looking for?
What's funny?
Right? I'm going to tell you because Adriana's.
What can you tell me?
Adriana, I'm going to tell you in code. So as we're not supposed to be too deep in an interview.
Right.
If you go to a certain website, it says, you know, what we're, you know.
Right.
Yeah. Anyway, that's all I had to say. Drew, I'm listening to you. You're making things difficult on us.
It does. I do have a little more of a depth perception going on right there.
Yeah.
Be like a good salesman. Come in now.
Yeah. Come on. Get this done. very cool. We do know Adriana's 5'4", 112 pounds, blonde hair, hazel eyes.
Good, you got the press release.
Yeah, I got it.
You know what, Roy? I think maybe we needed to defy a little bit of something.
You know what? It's our show.
We don't have to go deep, but we get to the tip of it.
Just the tip.
That's all I'm going to give you.
So,
because you know, Roy, the question is, I have this for our buddy, and I'll give his initials DG. Then what the hell?
Yeah.
So we are, since There it is. This one. Since this guy and this guy were pros, we're going to dig. But we're still going to keep it. We're still going to keep a cloud.
You know what it's like? It's like when you're a kid and you're learning when you're raking leaves and weeds through dirt.
Yes.
To where you're still raking, but you're skimming the top. So you just get the leaves and you leave the dirt behind. That's what we're going to be doing.
You can have that pudding skin.
Aha!
But you go in that, below that, just below it. There's a little something, something.
Drew, the only browns I'm excited about are the browns that I had in my drawers.
The only browns I'm excited are the ones that are not in my drawers.
Ooh, that's a better. That's a
that
better
would be
take.
The anti skid mark right
better,
there.
Better trigger. It's
just, but the Jets cleaned it. They clinch it. The Jets or the Bills.
Last night, and Tampa Bay is not going anywhere. Not Tampa Bay. I mean, New England.
No. We already knew that.
Yeah. Wow.
We already knew that. But
yeah.
There you go.
So that's what we're gonna do. So we're gonna call our interview this week officially. Pudding skin.
So hey, pudding.
Hey, pudding.
We called her pudding. Do you think that'll fly?
Nah. Pudding skin's a lot better than duck butter. So
this is true.
Fabletics. Don loves Fabletics.
Yeah.
Tube casting, Tradio, love interest, Milano wigs, print model training.
Nice.
You know, we're gonna let you the lifeguard, dancer, the kiss, and extra.
Oh, look
at music this. Videos.
Please.
Come on. She can sing.
She's got this.
Athletic, proficient dance, club, freestyle, salsa, language, English, Spanish, bilingual.
We don't need 5'4", 112.
You kidding me?
It's all right there.
Ugh.
It's all right there. We have plenty to talk to her about right there. Currently, Ranch Cucamonga is 54 degrees. We have a high of, where is it? They only show me what's going on right now. I have 76 today. Ranch Cucamonga weather right there.
76 it's going to be, huh? You know, it was cool yesterday. Washed Don's car. And man, I just ran out of juice yesterday. I was washing the car and then I stopped.
You did too much.
I don't think I did.
Roy,
during the day. I was really afraid to bring the energy later because I was a little tired. But when I saw your lovely face and lovely Ari's lovely face and all the people, I felt energy.
The cast of character, it came in a group.
Yes.
It was the peer pressure, and it brought you in. It's like somebody laughing so hard, you have no idea why, but you crack a little smile.
I almost gave myself a little browns when I laughed.
Smile, a little something for yourself there.
Yeah, what was the line that made me just lose and you too lose your shit bad? When Sean said it was one word.
Good.
That's what it was. I started giggling and then I saw you lost your shit. I thought it was funny. I just
find out, and we'll talk more about this with him tomorrow. But and to find out that he's never seen it, it made sense.
Yeah. Was he just going off of somebody's reputation is why he wanted to play Cousin Eddie? We'll talk to him about that.
Yeah, we'll talk about it tomorrow. But yeah, it
I've never seen this movie. This is who I want to play. What the fuck?
Have you ever seen Spartacus? No, but I am Spartacus. But I've heard that line. I'm going to be Spartacus. So funny. And his lovely wife, Robin. She did so good.
So good. But my favorite part was we had to call Nora a couple times and she freaked out. Nora.
That was the best.
Love shit like that.
That was the best. So look for it on YouTube and
whenever it decides to show up.
Yeah, that's kind of. Yeah, it's the internet. We didn't make it. We just try to use it.
Oh.
Right? That's my answer to everything. With this internet. Hey, Jimmy, how come I can't hear you? Well, I'm not going to ask you if your speakers are plugged in. I'm not going to ask you if you got your headphones on. I'm not going to ask you if it's playing on the Bluetooth in your car. These are all grown-up things you need to worry about.
I don't know. I might ask if it's plugged, just at least powered up.
I'll think about it on the inside. I can't believe this asshole doesn't plug his shit in.
Real low. Like Todd?
Yeah. Ariana left because I had like three accents for him.
Like Todd, Thurston Magoo, and Todd.
and Mr. Magoo.
The Sugar Crisp Bear.
Can't get enough of that sugar. Yep. See? Yeah, right. Yeah. I did like him.
Oh, there you
go. Oh, mute. Hurry. Abort mission.
Wow, I almost didn't make the mute button. I could have blown a gasket or something.
Sure. We don't need that, Roy. Did you so we have 4 days till the lovely holiday of Christmas, and how is your countdown going, my friend?
Countdown's going okay. I had a little faux pas.
No, say it ain't so.
So let me tell you what happened to Roy.
What do you got, Roy? What happened to Roy?
Well, and Don, I got Don a few things coming from Amazon. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Delicious.
And yes. We decided to get my Madre a few things from Amazon as well.
Mm-hmm.
One thing exact. She could be listening.
Oh, okay.
Come on now.
Just trying to slip you up right there. Boom, boom.
What I did.
Came in here. Yes, what'd you do?
I ordered mom stuff. Then yes. I ordered Don stuff. And I'm following on my. And I ordered myself a pair of shoes I wanted.
Okay.
You know, got to get something for me.
A little something for yourself while you're in. You know,
a little something for me.
And Clark, if it's okay, I want to get you something real nice.
Real nice. So, you know what? I was waiting for Richard to do the blessing. I was waiting for that, but it didn't happen.
I love Uncle Lewis.
Okay.
The blessing.
So I ordered them all and I'm tracking them and I'm like, oh! I did that. And I went, God, and I'm still a little upset about it.
It's a little Roger Rabbit.
Right I was there. Checking the status of delivery. It said it should be here Sunday. Two of the gifts are one gift in my shoe.
Right.
And I realized that the shipping address was still Texas. So I sent my shit and Don shit to my mom. So mom's gift will be there Tuesday.
Don's gift will be back in February.
Yeah, some of ours arrived yesterday, and another one was running late, of course, supposed to be there yesterday, but won't be there till today.
That's awesome.
So now part of Don's gifts are in Porter, Texas.
Oh, good. I hear it's lovely this time of year.
Yeah.
Isn't it, Art? Is that close to you, Art?
God bless America.
Oh, my God. That is pretty good, Roy.
I feel awful, though.
Well, yeah, but you feel more pissed at yourself.
Right, but that, I know, but it really, and she's like, let it go. I'm like, hold on a minute. She goes, I understand. And I'm like, God, I can't believe your shit's going. And I said, okay, here's the deal. Here's why not. Is you know, if you were in my shoes, you'd be like, son of a bitch. It would make you mad. And I'd be the one telling you, it's all right. It's no big deal. It's coming.
Right. You got to take turns.
But, Jimmy.
Right.
And I remember when I went to go out, I saw the mailing address and I changed it. I remember looking at it on my screen.
Yeah,
that means you have to fly me out there to open them. Oh, look at Art, 5 minutes away. Art, see? Swing on over to my Madre's
if you can. Well, I had a faux pas myself when I, you know, when you first move, your new address isn't flowing right out. It doesn't just come right off. It doesn't roll off the tongue. You know, you kind of got to go. Where am I at now? Because I live in places for years. I don't live for months. You know, so I remember the addresses. Well, I got here. Yeah, had to run it through. In fact, I put a little post-it notes. It's in my notepad on my phone. Well, I guess at one point I entered in one digit off on the end. Totally forgot about it because I've got it down now. Because, you know, I learn quickly. I learn good, Roy.
I'm a good learner.
I learn good.
I learn gooder.
I learn good. Well, I ordered some from eBay, and as soon as it shipped, I realized it auto-filled in the very first time I put the address in.
Uh-huh.
That was one digit off.
Right.
I went, son of a bitch. But there's no other digit here on my address, meaning that the next digit up isn't across the street.
You know, right.
You got odd even.
I get it.
Mine ends. in my little street here, if you were looking for my address, you would go, well, it's got to be this one because none of the other ones will ever make sense. It's not concurrent.
Right.
You would break it down and go, well, it's this one.
Right.
Well, I said, well, turns out I got a notification it delivered Saturday. Now, listen, it was coming from the USPS.
Now, listen.
It's coming from the USPS, okay? So I figured it gets here whenever, okay? Because Everything's such a mess. I'm not that guy. I'm like, whatever. It's going to get here. I put enough time in it to be lost and come back and boomerang around if it needed to.
Right.
So estimated delivery was today or Tuesday, tomorrow. Okay. Well, it got delivered Saturday. I'm like, well, bingo. I guess they took care of that one digit off.
Well, bully.
Bully. So I go to the mailbox. It's not there. Empty mailbox. Shows it was delivered.
Oh, here we go.
I said, that digit. Damn it, Jimmy. You're such a dummy.
Who's got it?
Right. So what I did yesterday morning is I put a little note on we have the block of mailboxes like you have.
Uh-huh.
So I put a note out there. If anyone got one for James Shaw, please pop it on my porch. Appreciate it. Thank you. Well, the mail lady apparently was working yesterday, saw her pull up, and she goes, you know, I thought it might have been you. She goes, it's back in the office. If you want to go get it, you can get it now. I'll bring it back tomorrow. And I said, you know, you can bring it back Tuesday if you want.
Right.
I'm just glad you recognize it. So we took care of identification, last names. So now, and real sweet mail lady too. She goes, oh, I knew it was you. I should have done it. And I said, no, you're cool. I'm going to live this whole Sunday without that little package. See, that's how you got to handle holidays, man. Got to handle life like that. And, you know, you'd order something from Amazon like last year. Any year besides this year, you order Amazon next day. Boom, done. Anybody. Bam. Well, now it's whenever. So I think, Roy, that these big companies now are taking advantage of us. Going, ain't got to hurry. It's not like it. They have an excuse now to kind of F us. So I think everybody should not have Amazon Prime anymore.
Oh, really?
I think everyone should cancel their subscriptions and show them now that, hey, you can still deliver because now all the safety things are well in place.
Mm-hmm.
There's no excuse now not to get it the way you used to. Because everyone's fully staffed. I used to work at Amazon and all my friends are still busy and working. So now you're all taking advantage of this Prime thing, giving me 3 to 5 days shipping because of pandemic.
So kind of like Joe Pesci says, they're fucking you in the shipping.
Yes.
Except the drive-through.
Yeah. What was that? Eddie Murphy?
No, it was Joe
Tommy
Pesci.
Tommy Davidson. They fuck you in the drive. No. Who said that?
It was Joe Pesci.
That's right. Lethal Weapon. You're right.
Jeez.
You're right. My bad.
Jeez. They always fuck you in the drive-through.
That's right. That's just my little conspiracy theory. I think they kind of think they got us. And I would like to start that campaign for everybody to just, why did you like not renew?
But here's how stupid we are.
We already know how stupid we are.
No, I am. I meant we as a house, I as a person, because there's no stupid genes in the Donster.
Well, those ones you had with the decorated pockets, those were kind of stupid.
It
just blew right by it.
I know it. I don't know when we get charged for it, but for somehow we both have our own Amazon Prime accounts.
Right.
Why?
Well, for Christmas shopping and birthdays, that's probably the best.
Well, why would I do Prime for that? Why would I just do regular and then just pay shipping?
Well, yeah, exactly. Now you just go regular because that's when you're getting stuff now.
Right.
In my opinion, and that's just me and my evil thoughts.
Right. So, and here's the thing. I know they are. No, it wasn't Chris Rock. It was Pesci. Anyway.
They were both in that scene, though.
In the Lethal Weapon scene?
Yeah.
We shouldn't both have... Whoa. You want a break?
No, this... just...
Hey, Jimmy,
why my electronics are so messed up. Jesus Christ.
That was hilarious. I don't remember where I was going because that threw me off. So I don't know when we get charged.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm sure we are.
Right.
So once in a while, I don't even know how much that costs.
What is that, like $100 a year?
Is it?
How long? How much? Yeah, $99, $100, something like that.
So at some point, we're going to have to get charged for that shit.
Yeah.
I don't get it. So I got to cancel that shit, because if we're paying $100 for that.
I'm just saying. Well, you do get the videos and the movies and all that. I mean, there's that caveat, but that's not why people got it. That came along with.
Well, yeah. Hmm. Okay.
So I'm just saying, if you're getting it 3-4 days, then you don't need Prime. Look at your finances.
I don't know where it's at.
You don't know where your finances are?
I don't know. We should be able to find it. I don't know. I'm a little confused now. Because you would think I would notice all of a sudden your house getting banged for $100, or your house.
Well, yeah, but do you remember a few shows ago, maybe a couple months ago, that you you went through some things. Ariana goes, wait a minute, she was being charged for like 3-4 subscriptions she totally forgot about.
Right, right.
Money in the bank, baby. Money in the bank. So well, did you? So what are you going to do with the presents? Are they going to get back to you in time, or are you just going to bring out a printed photo like you were 10 years old? This is what I wanted to get you.
Well, kind of. But here's what I'm thinking. I love a parade. No, I think here's what.
What's going on, buddy?
But I'm thinking. didn't get to it in time.
You got a nice slow build up to this. You got us all on the edge of our seats. No, and what I'm thinking is, what I'm really thinking is.
I thought you were going to finish that.
No, I'm filling for you. I'm doing filler.
I see. We weren't
there. My sister's right. Just give her some cash. Here you go, babe. What's for breakfast? Toss her a Benji.
You know, give her a little
slap on the ass. Don't make my eggs runny this time.
I had old guy Tom Ocean, the guy's name was.
Give her a C note, send her on her way.
And it wasn't Billy Ocean's son or dad, because he spelled it O-W-S-E-A-N, different. Anyway.
Suddenly.
He used to, and I'll go back to here's the deal with me. So he said on Mother's Day, for Mother's Day and birthdays, he would go to the grocery store and buy his wife, you know, eggs, bacon, food, and all that, you know, all that stuff. So his gift to her was she didn't have to go to the grocery store before she made his breakfast.
All right.
That's what he would do. So, hey, I saved her. She'd have to go to the grocery store, go to my breakfast. Now she can make my breakfast without having to leave the house.
Well, that's the gift that keeps on giving.
Right. So
all year.
So here's what I think is going to happen. I told Mom, I said, well, whatever you got to do to ship it, let me know. I'll send you some money. I'll probably have to Venmo it to my sister. And I know what she's going to do already. I thought about it. Dawn thought about it. Is she's going to go to UPS store, whatever they do in Porter, Texas. I don't know if they go to the Pony Express there. I don't fucking know. And she's going to pay extra and get it here in time. And they go, no, I got it. So now we're going to pay $800,000 for, I almost said what I bought Dawn, to get it here in time.
Well, it seems to me like you're not going to pay $800,000.
Yeah, but that's not right.
That's not right, but that's what they do. You have to let them do what they do. That's the thing, though.
With moms?
Yeah.
Yeah.
If they say, listen, I'm going to pay for it, and you go, do the obligatory, come on, you don't have to. But on the inside, you're going, hell yeah, get that shit over here.
So
and then you go, thank God Mom's here. Because it would ruin Dawn's Christmas if she didn't have a present, Roy.
Yeah. Come on. So the original, and this is what I was looking at on the backside, the original, they fuck you at the drive-thru, was with Glover and Gibson. The original. Now the second one, he brought back a callback in the movie that Chris Rock was in, which was one or two movies later, where he added cell phones to the thing.
Packed.
So I wanted to make sure I was right.
Afghanistan.
You know, correct me up when they did the one scene with him where he went into the embassy and went. Joe Pesci was laughing about it when he goes, "You went in there," and he goes, "He said you were black." The face he makes when he does it reminds me of Sean as a black man.
Yeah. Black. They got art there. Porter will have a tweaker run it out to you. Porter's a lot like Fontaine. So sorry to hear that.
They have a nice, I don't know, their neighborhood and their home's brand new and all that. I don't know. Important. It's like Kingwood, but I guess it's just out of Kingwood. I don't know where it's at. Here, let me just put the address in chat. You guys
An art swing by.
Art swing by, pick it up, take it over there for my mom. I can't believe it.
And there's a quick picture of the show last night. All 10 screens lit up.
There it is. Is that the one you took?
I just screenshot it off the chat? Off YouTube. Yeah.
Oh, okay. Because Don took one too.
Right. I've got that in there. But yeah, there's our. And we were loaded, dude. That was all 10 cameras fired up.
Yep. And the only thing that got tough is when we all, like when Ellen and I had to sing together, that was hard.
Yeah. And the Har bottles moving furniture through.
Furniture. Yes.
You know what it looked like here? An armoire behind us.
It reminded me of Mark and Brian dropping the Yule log. Yep. Boom. That's the biggest log we've ever had, Dad. not in a log like you thought I meant. I just, oh, sorry.
Going back again. Don't start. Don't start. We'll get me going. The moment's over.
Where are we going?
The moment is over.
No, it's not. I'm going to.
Well, we do.
That was Eddie Murphy.
So is Don's gifts getting here on time?
I don't know.
We can assume that your mother is going to handle that, right?
We can assume that it'll probably.
She's sitting there in all that retirement money, just going. It's now irritating. It's like, ship it overnight. It's on me.
She hit me last night and said the second one didn't arrive. And I got the notification arriving by 9. And then I looked again and it said, there's a problem, running late. Should be tomorrow. We'll let you know what the next steps can be. Well, the next step should be is yesterday. Because I wanted to cancel them as soon as I found out.
Right.
But the problem is they were already shipped. So a cancel was, it pretty much said, might work. I was like, nah, just let it go.
A little trick that Ariana actually found out is sometimes if it doesn't show up and you cancel it, they refund you immediately, but you may get that in a few days again.
Hmm.
Or still. And then at that point, Roy, free.
It's free. At that point, what?
And at that point, Roy, it's free.
I like it.
Yeah, it happens.
I kind of like that free thing. No, yeah, that doesn't work. I don't want to take advantage of anyone.
It's like when you order something from TV and it says, act now, we'll double your order. Well, then you know the thing's a piece of shit. Why would you need a spare? That's how I always look at that.
Okay.
So you see the infomercial for the Flobee.
Right.
Does this, that, the other thing, boom. Act now in the next 20 minutes. We'll send you a second Flobee at no charge. Well, why would that one break? Why would I need two?
Well,
that's the mentality. That's how they get you.
Well,
that's telling you the quality of their product. They're not backing up because they're going to send you two just in case one of them's a piece of shit.
Well, one of them is.
And they're sending it for free. Where's the profit margin? That means it's junk.
Well, here's what
materials ever used.
And some things that bother me, I believe in giving back like big companies do all the time and blah, blah, blah. And then like you're getting another one for free. And it's kind of like when you're, So it's kind of like when you're like you with XM.
Yes.
You know, it's like you're going to fight them and the people are already paying. So when it's all of a sudden, yeah, it's on sale. Like here's a good one. Kohl's. Okay.
Yes.
Regular price, $69.95. Kohl's cash. Okay. Got some Kohl's cash if we buy it. We're going to use some of that. And it's 40% off. And we got another $10 coupon. You know, I understand it's a deal.
And if you return an Amazon product that day,
yeah,
25% for the day.
Right. So you know what that tells me? That means they're overpricing shit all the time.
Exactly. That's my mentality too. It means you bought that sweater for $1. And you're charging me $70.
Yeah.
Which is a great gig. I mean, if I could do that, I'd be all over that shit.
Right.
If I can do that markup on anything, I will not belittle them for that, but I will look around going, why would you, okay.
Why all of a sudden is this
okay.
a dollar?
That's why when we were younger and poorer, we used to get our gifts on the day after Christmas. It worked out good when we lived in Arizona because we can get away with that shit. Won't be able to come home until like day after tomorrow. Hurry up, run to the mall.
Right.
Spend a fraction of the money.
A fraction. And every, like this year, last year, I forgot when I put the Christmas lights up. Last year, I threw a lot of shit away when I put them away.
You wanted to upgrade.
I'm going to upgrade and do it.
Worn and torn.
Right. And I forgot all about it until this year when I pulled everything out and went, where's all this shit? Like I had like 36 candy canes that go around the house that string lights at least.
Right.
And all of a sudden they're gone. Now I got to get new ones. Well, I didn't feel like it, so I didn't get them. Year, like last year we did it. I'm sure the thought was, hey, when Christmas is over, we're going to buy a bunch of that shit brand new for like 10 cents on a dollar.
Sure.
And I'm going to have, you know, joy to the world. Like I'll have that next year.
Is that the
but
plan?
No. Yeah. But no, I will forget or I'll say, I don't want to spend money on that shit. I got to go pack it. I got to put it up there. Cause I used to have like three tubs for yard alone, front yard. I got one tub left. Oh, two, because I have a full-size Christmas tree I put out there. But other than that, I got one tub. And because we didn't have a lot of people over last night for our normal Christmas, we didn't feel like decorating inside. Gotcha. So, Don, I don't know if you're still listening right now, but I think everything in the garage that's not up, shit can it. All of it. We didn't need it.
My thing is, we've lived in an apartment for so long, I haven't decorated a house, the outdoor lights. But you've seen my abodes. The Santa, the reindeer, the lights.
Yes.
I'm not really a big fan of Christmas, but I did get into a big fan of decorating the outside, the exterior. You've taught me everything I knew about exterior illumination. I love it. And when you're doing something, then you think you still have it, just like you were saying.
Yeah.
And then Ariana has seen my houses there too. And she goes, so where's those lights you used to have? And I'm like,
yeah. Oh, those.
And then your brain's going, oh yeah, I remember those. Those are the ones. Oh, wait. Oh yeah. I got rid of all that shit.
Well, and here's the deal. What happened is another deal is what happened. I went by George's house and she's got it. You probably see on Instagram. It's blown up lights everywhere. Mm-hmm. To blow up Santa on the roof, hanging onto the chimney or whatever it is. And they got shit all over the place. They're everywhere. And I got done. And she's like, well, that's how, you know, the Brewster thing did it. I've learned that's how you do Christmas. And I'm all proud and everything. I come over here. I got shit. So now as I get older, I'm you know, probably in 2 or 3 years, there's going to be no lights and a sign on my yard that says, keep off my fucking lawn. I mean, that's probably the road I'm going.
Don't touch.
Right. Oh, I guess I can't throw away the end stuff. Oh well, I tried.
Well, Don, you didn't have to. We didn't have the Christmas play.
But if we didn't need it this year, we don't need it next year. Just boot all of it.
See, that's the beauty of it. Once you get rid of it, and then you don't have it, then you're like, all right, dude. Okay, where am I at here? You kind of thin it down a little bit.
Yeah, I'm gonna. Don't make me go all Clark on you. I'm a rant. No, you will always decorate. Oh, I've been told how things happen now. Perfect.
She has spoken.
And she learned from Sean.
She learned that shit from Sean.
Merry Christmas, Tony.
Hey, Tony, good morning.
I don't know. I would really like to, because I know it comes out earlier in every year, but jump out on it like September, October and buy all the new shit and draw out what I want, rent the crane. Do the whole thing.
But doesn't everybody do that right after the holidays, even during it? You know, next year we get to jump on this, say January, February, and then it's just like our Christmas play. We started talking about it in July. We're like, yeah, okay, no problem. September, boom, October, November, done. And then we're like, holy shit, and we're up doing stuff.
I'm buying the script in November, and Jimmy and Ari are burning midnight hours writing it together.
Oh yeah, she already got us found us a script for next year.
Oh, let's share. Come on.
What's the movie? A Christmas Story.
We can't do, there's not enough people in it.
Yeah, actually, funny enough, there is. She found a play script version of it, and it's actually really good. There's like, how many roles? Like 19? 19 roles. They did it with like 5-6 actors.
There's 19 roles in A Christmas Story.
Yes.
Well, I'm going to tell you right now, Jimmy, the way you did narration, the narration part is going to be awesome. If that's what you want to do, we'll talk about it through the year.
I was exhausted. But yes, and it's not so dependent on it. They actually did a pretty good job. I'll send it over to you.
Oh, cool. Because I thought A Christmas Story last year, and it just, there wasn't enough people.
Right. And we were thinking about that too. And then you find that conversion where someone did it for us, like the radio plays for you were finding when we were first doing it.
It just doesn't seem like, I'm trying to think. There's Ralphie and mom and dad. The little brother doesn't talk.
That's my part.
We'll
give Sean that one.
There's the guy at the Christmas tree farm. That's 6.
I'll send it to you. I mean, there's dual roles, obviously, but there's enough in there. And like I said, they had 5-6 actors, and you know how we are. Please.
Well, hopefully we'll be in a situation better than we are now. We'll be able to put up the stand-up mics and do it like normal.
Right.
Where everyone's together. But we'll see, hopefully. Oh, Sean's listening. Sean's about ready to see the cookie, and he's getting messed up.
You got to take a picture of not the cookie. I just want to see where she's sitting in relation to you.
Well, she's not there. Remember, she doesn't come until after.
I know, but I want to see where she's
right. Right.
He's sitting there.
Sean, I got she's one for
over
you
right there. We definitely don't want to see it. We do not want to see it.
Got one for you, Sean. Ready? Good.
Sean Williams, you dog, you love you, man.
Love you too, Sean. That was awesome. That was fun. Yeah, I like the hat, and I like that Sean went the extra mile,
dude,
and put the RV behind him.
Yes, RV behind him. The hat. Your microphone, Sean. Oh my God, your microphone! It sounded wonderful. The velvety tones,
Sean Williams
of SW. There.
You know what it makes you feel like? Makes you feel like you're in a blanket, and Sean just pours the hot chocolate on you.
He had that whole berry white thing. He was all up in that thing going, I'll tell you what, Clark. That was good. It just flowed.
Get yourself something real nice.
Yeah, I mean, you see him on there, he had that thing right there. Just, I'll tell you what. And I'm like jealous because I got all this gear and he sounded better than me.
And all of a sudden,
son of a bitch.
All of a sudden, Sean, Cousin Eddie comes off with like, throw me your squirrel covers.
The only good thing about my performance, he turned Cousin Eddie into Barry White.
Barry White. And suddenly, no, run.
Don't forget the rubber sheets and the gerbils.
That was a lot of fun.
Bring it on in.
That was a lot of fun. We digress back. We need to talk to you about that a little bit, Sean. But we're going to wait till tomorrow.
You got Cousin Eddie on the line. I can help you tonight. That's right. You get the rubber sheets and the gerbils. Let Cousin Eddie take care of everything else. I like that. That's how I'm going to talk now.
Are you?
That's how I'm going to do the show.
Please don't.
So, when did you start doing your acting? Yeah, that's good. That's nice. Real nice.
Real nice. So give me this one, Jimmy. So I don't need, I'm trying to do it like you, but I'm just going to tell you the facts. So try this one, Jimmy. I see you're 5'4", 112 pounds. Blonde hair, hazel eyes. All right, Jimmy, make it freaky.
I see you're on the shorter side. That's all I can start with.
Shit.
Have you always been that small and diminutive? That's a big word right there. That's an encyclopedic word right there.
Big word.
Diminutive. He took his shirt off, no one noticed. No, we did not. You did not take your shirt off.
I took mine off. That was, I'm telling you, I just had on a Santa jacket and a tie. That was my chesticles.
I've never seen such wrinkly skin.
Is it wrinkly?
Didn't you have
that's
like
abs, baby.
You had a crease in the wrong places if that was a natural torso for you.
Well, when it's been hiding under this roll of fat for this long, it gets misplaced.
It's getting air.
Yeah. It's kind of like when you put something in bubble wrap and you ship it And you get it there and it's like, whoa, what happened? It kind of bounced around. That's what happens here.
Gotcha.
Don't make me take off my elf shirt. I'll show you.
Dawn, you need to run downstairs pronto.
Stop this.
Run downstairs pronto. Put that man in a straitjacket. Shirt's on.
Oh, my God. I gotta tell you. One day we'll tell you that.
Yeah. Floating probably shelves.
Not. Huh?
Floating shelves.
Floating shelves?
Floating shelves right there behind me.
I thought you said floating shelf. And ready?
Floating elves.
It cracks me up. A floating shelf. That's the thing now. I get it. I understand. A floating shelf is a deal. Suspended, I got floating shelves.
The illusion of suspension in midair.
What do they come up with floating shelves? Dude, it's fucking mounted to the wall. It's not. I understand that's what they call it. And you didn't make up the word. And they look good. There's no brackets. I understand all that, but
non-visible bracketry creates the floating illusion.
How about I put some shelves on the wall without any brackets? No, floating shelves.
No, see, that's how we watch all these reality TV shows. So now we have to go extra mile. How was your dinner? It was good. I liked the sweet and the sour of it. And people, no, you don't know any of that. Stop it. And I watch a lot of those car shows on Motor Trend channel, and every time they say they're doing something, they're like, say they're putting the fender on, they're working the body work, and then they cut to the dude going, well, you know, if that metal twists and bends, it can compromise the whole build. And that's how they do it. They just set themselves up to, and so people, I can't Roy.
Well, it's just building drama for no reason.
Exactly.
My favorite part of what I just said was before I said it's just building drama for no reason. It's very good on the radio before you say a sentence to go, that's really good to do that before you say anything on the radio and enunciate. So it's like, I'm going to say, Sean, you took your shirt off with no one noticed. I would say, Sean took his shirt off and no one noticed. So professional and so polished. Not everyone can do this.
Right.
God, I hate when I hear myself sometimes. Or
myself.
And I listen is the problem.
So Sean, you need to just sneak an angle of where that would be. I want to see the proximity between you and cookie area. Not cookie. Cookie area.
I don't want to see where it's
cookie
like,
adjacent over here.
Cookie adjacent?
Cookie adjacent.
Hmm.
Then Sean can go up to her going, I couldn't help but notice your cookie. Your cookie is staring at me. Who are you? They call me Cousin Eddie.
Who are you? They call me the Cookie Monster.
You can call me Eddie.
Our clock calls him Edward a couple times.
You did?
Yes, I know.
A couple times. That it is.
Let it go.
That
let
it is,
go.
Edward.
Let it go.
That it is indeed, Edward.
Okay.
That it is indeed.
Give it, Sean. Okay. He gets it.
Okay, he'll do it.
Beat that dead horse to frickin' whatever.
I just want to see the adjacent. That's all. Just want to see.
No.
How I don't not the actuality.
I don't want to anymore.
No, Sean's been a big part of our radio life, Roy. He shares. Well, we share. We're in. I'm invested.
Well, the only reason I'm thinking no is no. I got to stop myself. Good job, Roy. I stopped right in the middle. Good. You guys are all happy. I put the brakes on there. everyone in this room should be happy that I was able to snatch that from my brain and throw it away forever. threw it down my gullet. It's gone. So, Sean, I got to know, though. This is very important. More important than the cookie. You say?
How you say?
Did you put pellets in that barbecue yet? We'll talk more about it tomorrow, but get ready. We're going to have some barbecue. We're going to have some smoker talk.
And Ariana was all over that too. Ooh, we should get you a smoker.
Well, I got a thing from Sean. I don't know if he's completely happy, but we'll find out tomorrow. That's what
he's
you call
never completely happy.
That's what we call a tease.
I know, but he's never completely happy.
It's kind of like me saying tomorrow, I'm going to take off my shirt and do the show in my underwear. That right there is a tease.
No, what you say is I may take off my shirt. I may be underwearless.
You know what, Sean? That was big letters screaming at us. I feel the excitement. So I don't want to see the excitement come out in chat. I want to feel the excitement tomorrow in person. Well, that's what I'm thinking.
If I get a smoker, and I'm not saying I do, if, then we can do the three-way battle we were talking about.
Yeah.
All three of us cook the same, all three of us smoke the same thing, and then we grab the women types and then we mix them up and pick your man's meat.
Well, I like that we're going to smoke something first and then we're going to switch meat. So we're all going to be smoking and switching and meat, picking meat, picking meat. Oh my God. But Don, I mean, you know, I've smoked a while since, you know, I've had mine and I smoke out. And Don already knows what my meat tastes like. So I don't know. It might not be fair. Don, she's going to pick my meat. She's going to pick my meat just because of loyalty.
Oh, man. You know, what's the worst meal you ever had is when you were forced to eat it. Eat your cream spinach. No. Mm. Eat it. Oh, man.
Oh, no.
No.
I would have to switch it up. I'm going to do some ribs on Sunday. So we'll see how that goes because I want to change it up a little bit.
Okay.
I've been doing the ribs same way. They have the same taste. Gotta change it up.
Oh, I think you have a couple words, Don.
Oh, she's got some. I'm listening right now.
She has no words.
I think.
maybe not. What, Roy?
No, I was going to yell up there, but I think Kylie's up there, so I don't want to wake anyone up.
That's why. Let's do this.
Nah. No, I don't, you know, don't need. Oh, you know, it's funny. I switched back and forth. I just saw myself leaning out to look through the window. That's great radio too, Roy. Good stuff.
Means you're real.
Well, we are weird. We let you into our lives a little bit. We're talking about our meat, talking about smoking out.
Right.
Talking about all the things we need to be talking about in order to be successful. You know what? Someone put in that damn petition to get us on like radio. You don't want to do it?
I don't know if we got the resume for that.
Are you freaking kidding me? Did you hear us last night?
I'm playing with you, buddy.
Did you hear that? That was brilliant.
Oh, she says she's not there. Go for it.
Oh, she's not?
Storm the castle, Roy. She just dared you.
What the hell? Storm the castle. She just walked in here and then left?
She's a grown. She's all grown, man.
Oh, I know.
She don't need you. I need your
goddamn permission. I know.
I need your goddamn permission, Roy Brewster.
I don't even remember what I was going to yell now. I was going to yell something up there.
I was going to.
I was going to yell. I was going to show, I don't know. I was going to show something. I sent myself something in chat. That's what I'm looking for. And I just realized, I don't know why I do this. Oh, I know what it was.
What? Ah,
I wonder if we should do this tomorrow. I cannot forget to do this. Remind me, I'm going to write it down right here too, that we need to play a rousing round of the Christmas Carol game.
Okay.
I knew this is what I wanted to do. I knew there was a reason I was looking, but I don't want to, I think it might be fun. I think it might be fun. We're going to get interaction from the fans, from ourselves, and from the lovely Sean Williams.
Okay. Sounds good.
But I gotta look it up to make sure I can do it, but I'm sure I can. Because I'm not going to say I invented this. I heard somebody else doing it as I was driving around. I went, this is something that's going to be great that we can do together and have a lot of fun with. Which means it's probably going to freaking blow.
Most likely, yes. All right, so let's take a break. We got Adriana coming in a few minutes. It's Roy and Jimmy in the morning on YouTube, Facebook. Enjoy some karaoke if you dare. And if Roy dares, I shall not.
Jingle bell, jingle bell rock. Jingle bells swing and jingle bells ring. Snowing and blowing up. He said blowing bushels of fun. Now the jingle hop has just begun. Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell rock. Jingle bell chime and jingle bell time. dancing and prancing in Jingle Bell Square in the frosty air. What a bright time, it's the right time to rock the night away. Jingle bell time is the swell time to go riding in a one-horse sleigh. Giddy up, jingle horse, pick up your feet. Jingle around the clock. Mix and a mingle in the jingling beat. That's the jingle bell rock. This is like the chorus. They're like, jingle bell time, dancing and prancing, jingle bell square, in the frosty air. What a fun time, it is the right time to rock the night away. Jingle bell time, it's swell time. I'm coming back to go gliding in a one-horse sleigh. Giddy up, jingle horse, pick up your feet. Jingle around the clock. Mix and a mingle in the jingling beat. That's the jingle bell. That's the jingle bell. That's the jingle bell rock. I felt like a mix between Harry Connick Jr. and Michael Bublé right there. Just to let you all know. Right in the middle. Oh, we're going to do some Burl Ives right now. Oh, Rudolph, this is it. Get it. Have a holly jolly Christmas. It's the best time of the year. I don't know if there'll be snow, but have a cup of cheer. Have a holly jolly Christmas, and when you walk down the street, say hello to friends you know and everyone you meet. Oh, 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 the mistletoe hung where you can see. Somebody waits for you, kiss her once for me. Have a holly jolly Christmas, and in case you didn't hear, oh by golly, have a holly jolly Christmas this year. Have a holly jolly Christmas, it's the best time of the year. Have a holly jolly Christmas, and when you walk down the street, say hello to friends you know and everyone you meet. Oh, have a holly, oh, the mistletoe hung where you can see. Somebody waits for you, kiss her once for me. That's kind of weird. Have a holly jolly Christmas, and in case you didn't hear, oh by golly, have a holly jolly Christmas this year. Oh, oh no, Adriana's with us.
I know.
Oh, not figuring yet.
That made my day. I can't even tell you.
No, it doesn't.
You went a little soft. You went a little loud. I just love it. And also, I thought that line was so weird. I've thought it's so weird my whole life. Why do you want your friend to kiss his lady for you?
Right. A little odd.
A proxy in that situation. First, you got stranger danger. Come on. Please.
Can we put that in the category of Baby, It's Cold Outside?
Yeah.
That song has some controversy as well.
If you break it down and go all conspiracy on it, yeah, it's a horrible, horrible situation. But it takes away that warm, cozy it had all those decades. So I tend to ignore that. So Adriana Delgado, good morning.
Good Thanks morning. For joining How are us. You?
It's awesome. We're doing
awesome
good.
That you were here, but the problem is Jimmy brought you in and I didn't know you were coming in. And we all know because I shared a little bit earlier. Number one on your skills list on your bio is singing. So that was a little embarrassing. I'm going to Jimmy, have a good time.
I loved it. I love what you're wearing. And I'm just a happy girl right now. This is awesome. Great.
I came around in and Adriana's in the green room and I see her and I'm like, Oh God, she's staying. She started bopping her head. I said, okay, she's in. She knows the essence of Roy now.
I love music. I don't know about you guys, but I'm in Oregon right now for the holidays with my family, and I'm just nonstop listening to Christmas music.
Well, awesome. Yeah, it is the week. It's definitely the week to do that. I'm not really a big Christmas song fan for some reason, but as the days get closer, I got to give in a little bit, as in the decorations back here, sure.
I love it.
Good morning. How are you? We've only met on a couple Zoom meetings. We have a project we're all sharing coming up soon. But it was nice to meet you finally and talk with you and get a little background on you. And we got your little sheet there, and Roy's got a bunch of questions.
Roy's got questions.
I threw it towards you there.
It's great to meet you too, because after reading the script, you guys are such, I won't give anything away, but you guys are such an integral part of the script. You're kind of like essentially the streamline throughout the script. And so, it's really great to meet you.
Imagine the surprise we had when we read the script.
Oh, really?
We were that guy? Okay. We're those. Okay. No pressure. We're okay.
And do you feel that like some of the lines, it's odd that, you are portraying yourselves. Do you feel that those are lines that you would authentically say, or how was it reading lines that you are supposed to be saying yourself?
Well, actually, I think, and Jimmy may be there too. I think we've talked about it a little bit, is knowing Drew for a little bit, he kind of nailed it. Now, the cool part is he allowed us, if it doesn't quite feel like you, you can change it up a little bit.
Right.
He kind of nailed us personally, because Jimmy and I are not completely different. I mean, we know each other since fifth grade. We're friends. But we still have different ideas in the way we are. And he kind of, I think, hit it is a weird thing.
I love that. You guys have a great, I think, dichotomy. So that's why.
We've known each other since fifth grade. So we have, we can finish each other's sentence, or I can look at him again. We can be and go, oh God, no, don't. Here he goes. And the thing with us is we do stand-up comedy also. So with this upcoming project, the hardest thing for anyone to do is be yourself at the moment. It's like, okay, that's just you. And then you're forced to be you. And you're like, I don't know how to do me.
I totally.
How long have you been acting?
So I actually am a more recent college graduate. I graduated from TCU in Texas. I don't know if you guys are football fans at all.
Yes.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do you watch college football?
No, I watch more pro, but I do watch college football, but yeah, mostly pro football.
It was a big football school, which I loved. I had a great time there for that reason. But I graduated in 2019. So
where in Texas is this?
This is in Fort Worth. So it's
okay. We've got Roy's got a lot of Texas family there, and we've got some viewers in Texas listening right now too. So
gotta love Texas. I have quite the affinity for Texas and Texans after living there for 4 years. I graduated May of 2019, right before, that was, I guess, the last class to graduate before COVID hit, and they had to have virtual graduation. So really, really grateful for that. And I graduated with a degree in double major strategic communication, which is like marketing, advertising, and PR. And then my other half of my major was film, TV, digital media. So I was always in LA, kind of working on the other side of the camera per se. I had internships and jobs, and I've been, acting and singing since I was little here in Oregon. It's been something I just was kind of born doing straight out the womb. I would dress up in my mom's like long dresses and heels, and I would make them
act it out.
Singing Shania Twain and play when I was younger, The Princess and the Pauper in like second grade. It's just a part of who I am. I love creating things. I love just being able to transform yourself for the greater good of telling a story. And so when I moved to LA, I kind of had told myself and everyone that I was just going to take a job on the other side of the camera doing public relations. And I had a lot of internship experience. So it wasn't, you know, that difficult to get a job offer in that area, but my heart was just so, I felt very convicted to try something I wanted to try my whole life and something that I love so much, but I was just too afraid to try it. I was afraid of what people would say about me. I was afraid that because I, you know, had this great college education that I would have wasted that. There were just a lot of fears that came up, but I luckily was able to push through, and I was offered work pretty quickly after getting here with acting and modeling. And since then, you know, I found my agents and just worked my way up from the bottom. I've been in LA a year and a half.
Now, to me, it would seem like we all have that goal. Like, so we do stand-up comedy, and of course, we dream of the HBO special we saw when we were thinking about doing it. It, to me, though, it seems that it's easier to get into industry on the backside, like you were talking about, an internship or, you know, the behind-the-scenes stuff is a lot easier to get into the mechanism and kind of build up that way instead of saying being a waitress and going for all these calls and hoping something would happen, but at least almost networking, but on the smaller level. You start here, like we would go to comedy clubs when we wanted to do it, mm-hmm. do a couple open mics, but then we would just hang out.
Yeah, I think
that. And then you're, hey, Jimmy, what do you think? Okay, I know him. Roy, you've been here before, and you kind of get to know it before you get to really get to do it.
Yeah, that's a really valid point. I think, first off, whoever, you know, suggested that actors and actresses should be waiters and waitresses, I don't know where the heck they came up with that, because you had a 9-to-5 schedule. If you have to go to an audition, what do? I knew that was not going to work. I mean, there were days when, and you understand this, you have to come at the drop of a hat and you have to fight LA traffic because there are so many other people that are readily available. So, and that said, to your point, the one difficult thing about, you know, working behind the scenes, whether it's in public relations or whether it's being a producer or director, is I think people might question your motives.
For lack of a better term, kissing my ass to get something else.
Exactly. I think there's, you know, let me know if you agree with me or not, but there's kind of this aura in Los Angeles, maybe New York as well, where people are skeptical of people's motives because everyone is trying to get in somewhere, make it somewhere. And so
I think of that as a life lesson too. It's like, yeah. You know, you know, you have a relative you haven't seen forever. They show up. You're like, okay, what are you doing here? What are you, come on in, but what are you doing here? Yeah.
Right.
Well, yeah. We would get calls like, we live outside of LA, but we get a call to go do a spot at the Comedy Store. Mm-hmm. And just like you said, you got to go, oh my God, I got to go now. So you got to get in your head that you're going to perform, but then you have to hit the traffic, drive, hope you get there, wonder where you're going to be. And then by the time all that's in your head, you still have to perform. And you're just like,
so accurate and so well put. You're so right. Yeah.
I think one thing Adriana brought up that was, you have to be there at the drop of the hat. Okay. If someone calls, you have to be there, and it may not even always be, and I may be wrong. Maybe your view on it is it may not be what you're going to do. You may be there for that reason, but you don't know who else is going to be there. You might be put in that one situation, and that situation may not go as you had planned or had hoped, but who else is there, or who else did you meet, or who else saw you? And you can never miss that opportunity to get out there, because that could lead to something else. It's kind of like you said, how you people would say that you wasted your degree. Mm-hmm. Okay. I'm a huge believer and this is where Jimmy and I get different. I get into the mental thing of it. Jimmy's like, it's bullshit. But I mean, there's two sides to everything. And that's why we get along. But yeah. How do you feel about, you got your degree. Yeah. You went to TCU. Everything you've done through your life, regardless if it's a bad audition, a good audition, your college degree, has put you where you are right now. So you can't negate any part of that.
You are so right. I'm so glad you brought that up, because I'm a firm believer in that. I'm very openly a Christian, and I really, truly believe that. That's why I also really just agreed with this storyline. There's so much about conviction and soulmates and just kind of pursuing what you feel is in your heart above, you know, against all of our adversity. And I think that, you know, everything happens for a reason. I've been living with that mentality for a long time. And you're so right. There have been situations in my life where I've showed up to something, whether it was volunteering or whether it was an audition or whether it was to help someone move. And I happened to meet someone who changed my life, whether it was for my career or just personally.
Well, yeah, you know, we found out, and I'm sure you think the same way, is a lot of times with these kind of careers is 90% of it is knowing people, being a part of it. And it sounds like you enjoy the whole process, not just I'm going to be a star on the screen, but, you know, we've been extras in movies and all that. Even being that part, you watch the whole process and you go, this is fascinating. I just love how this works. In fact, we did one film we did as extras, and the second AD sucked. I thought he was awful. Not a lot of continuity. And so I learned that going, oh my God, this guy is off. And so now when I watch movies, I go, okay, see that? That guy crossed at the wrong time. And, you know, those inner details, you know, it's like the TV show, How It's Made. You know, you see how shock absorbers are made, but now I want to see how you made that machine that made the shock absorbers. You know, you just get into it.
From a young age, I would go to the movie theater and then I would come home immediately and go on YouTube and research like behind the scenes of all of the footage. I was so fascinated with creating the story. And that's how I knew I really wanted to be in this industry, because I didn't care so much about the finished picture. I really cared about how it was made.
Here's what I do now. It's awful, but it's what I do. Every time I finish watching a movie, I immediately IMDb it. I go through the did you know trivia part. Where was it filmed? Shooting locations. I just get right into that. I'm such a dork on that, but that's exactly what I do.
We're akin in that way. Absolutely. I love those little facts.
We produce comedy shows too. And, you know, and it's not about us at that point. It's about our performers and who we hired to do the show. Yeah. And I just love when they're performing well and we're in the background. You know, it's just, we're just part of it. And that's always just, that's even better than doing your own set on stage.
Oh yeah. Observing, I think, is one of the most like powerful things you can do. You learn so much from just watching people.
Now, we can't give away too much of the movie, obviously, like none of it. But what we
Adriana, he dropped that on me last night. I'm like,
okay, all right.
But there's been stuff in trailers that so that's okay. We can be kind of general. We know the movie is very, it's pretty deep.
Yeah.
So when it gets that way on your side personally, do you see a force in your life that affects you like deeply, like is maybe a driving force or your rock or soulmate or anything like that? I mean, is there someone in your life that drives you like that or more than one person?
Yeah, that's a really good question. And I agree. That's definitely a big theme in the script. I think for me, as I mentioned, my faith is really, really important to me, because there's not much that's consistent and constant in this world, and particularly in the city I live in and the industry I'm in. And you really have to find your own grounding and your own constant in order to be okay.
For us, or me, actually, when you get into it, the disappointments actually kind of mellow you out to understand how it works, but still keep you driving to do it.
Yes.
You know, you have to have a bad set, a bad gig, a bad audition to get the better one.
Absolutely.
And but when you see a bad producer, you see a bad producer treat a comic bad or a show bad, then you go, oh man, that is messed up. But then it doesn't turn you away from it. It's like, well, I'll do it better, or I'll find better people to work with.
Absolutely.
And just kind of change your path a little bit.
Yeah. It's not, you know, you really cannot be faint of heart, and you have to have thick skin. I know that's the most overused phrase in this industry, but it's true. To answer your question, definitely faith is a big part of that. Also, I'm really, really blessed to be very close to my family. And it's really great to see them right now. I just got back like yesterday. I think it's tricky with your family. I don't know if you guys can give insight to this, but when you kind of take the leap and say you want to pursue something that's a little more risky and it's a little more, well, you're, you know, statistically destined to fail. sometimes that can cause a ridge in any relationship, whether it's like a partnership you have, a friendship, but especially with your family. So I'm really grateful that my parents, who are not at all involved in that, my dad's a doctor, are supporting me just emotionally and really believe in me. That's meant the world to me. And I know that not everybody gets that experience. So I definitely don't want to take it for granted. And I would be remiss if I didn't say I was grateful for that.
Yeah. You hear all those stories, and I'm super fortunate. My family just backed me up 100%. I said, I want to do this, and I'm doing it basically late in life. And, you know, mid 40s, I said, you know, I'm just going to do this. And the family just totally backed me up, friends and family. I will say it's hard on a relationship if you're in one. That's just inevitable, I guess. I mean, you find that out. But as far as family and friends, oh my God, 1,000%.
Yeah. That's so great. They were so supportive.
And you know, my mom would say, don't say anything about the family. And then my dad's going like this. Go ahead. It's hilarious. Knock it out.
I never thought about that with stand-up comedy, because obviously you pull a lot of your comedy from your life. And
Jimmy had a good take on it, about depending how successful you are is how much you could use them. So if you use them in the skit, so it's like, okay, I really beat up my brother really bad. That's worth a couch or a car or something like that. Jimmy, didn't you use something like that?
Yeah. I said if a bit I did about my brother made it to an HBO special, I said new set of tires. And if it was my mom and dad, then they got new furniture. I figured I'd just plan it that way and give them a little cash incentive.
Okay, now I get it. Now I understand how it works.
Yeah.
So Adriana, you obviously been on, and we've, you know, obviously we've had sets that we've done out and really not done well, and we talk about them after. Two things is kind of like, how do you deal with something when you go out to an audition and it doesn't go the way you had planned? Like, you just, maybe you weren't in your head, or maybe you just didn't perform like you thought. And what is maybe an example, if you have one, that when you got there and left, or even the situation, was maybe your worst audition you can remember?
Yeah, good question. You know, another interesting part about that is I've struggled with like perfectionism a lot of my life. I'm very type A, and it's just something I've worked through. So I've gotten a lot better at being able to talk about my failures, whereas before I was like, don't let people know, don't be vulnerable. But now I've really come to a place where I love talking about my failures, and I love hearing about other people's failures, because that's how you grow. You do not grow if you don't. You either win or you learn. So with that said, just recently, I really would love to book a TV show, is the truth. It's consistent work, at least for a while. And you can really grow close, you know, with the people who you're working with, since you're with them all the time. And it was for this TV show, and they had kind of reached out to me, to my agent, and said, we would like you to go for this role. It's a hippie. And okay. I've never been cast as that. But I was like, hey, let's go for it. But I felt, I'm very analytical, which sometimes hurts my performance. So I'm thinking, I'm not right for this role at all. Absolutely not. I saw people going before me. I was like, I would hire them in a second. I would not hire them. And that's, you can't think like that. Like, oh, that's the worst thing you could say. So I go in and I can memorize things pretty quickly, and just everything went out the door. Truly.
How do you do, how would you do, say,
guys, oh my gosh.
How would you do research for, say, that role, hippie? They say, we need you to be a hippie. What would your process be on something like that? Would you, obviously the look, you'd have to, you know, once you put the clothing on and the then you feel it a little more, but, you know, go watch an old movie, or how would you research, say, we need you to be a hippie?
You know what? That's a really big part of it, I think, is the look. Once you are able to transform yourself physically, it can really affect you mentally, emotionally. So, you know, who cares about brushing your hair? You're a hippie. You know, put on a loose, I wore a David Bowie t-shirt.
There you go. Yeah.
And some bell-bottom jeans, and I really just tapped into that part of myself. I'm from Portland, so I'm big on composting. I'm big on recycling. I'm big on just cruelty-free stuff. I love the earth and the environment. That's the most Portland thing you can say ever.
The most Portland thing, yes. Very Portlandia, yes.
I know, right? So I plugged into that side of myself. There's a side of yourself in every character you portray. And I think you are not doing your job correctly if you just try to embody somebody else. Because there's a part of you, I believe, that can come out in that character. So, but I guess I just didn't do a good enough job because I was so in my head. And
What kind of parts do you go for? Like,
thank you.
Do you look for a certain part or do you just take kind of what comes to you just to see what you can do with it?
Absolutely take what comes to me. I'm really grateful for roles that maybe push what I would expect. I know maybe I didn't sound like that because I mentioned I didn't think I was right for the hippie role, but I get cast a lot for like girlfriend, you know, like what else, like action star, stuff like that. I was like a femme fatale character a couple times last year, like when I was first starting out, which makes sense. I get that objectively. I see that, but it's always nice. For example, in this film, I am not anything like that.
Right. You're not that little side character, the little embellish that scene or character for a couple scenes kind of thing.
Yeah. Embellished is a good word. Yeah.
Flashback to the former girlfriend and there's a scene of you with the character kind of thing.
Yeah.
So I want to go back just a couple minutes when you said you got to the audition and you said everything was gone, because this has happened to me before. Really? I've hit stage at an improv and I want to know how you got it back and how you worked around that. So was it just when you showed up, you're good at memorizing lines, you're ready to go, and then it really completely left? I mean, it was just left your head?
So, I mean, I was able to say some things. I guess that would be grateful. That would be horrible. I don't like to practice things too much because I think it comes across over practice. I don't know if that's the case with your stand-up.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Yes.
So, you know, I rehearsed it enough to get the lines down, and I have never messed up lines before. That's one thing I don't mess up. And because I was so in my head, I had a reader who was reading with me. And it was weird, though, I have to say, because in the middle of the script, they broke the fourth wall. Mm-hmm. And so we were like, okay, when you break the fourth wall, move over, look over here, and then go back. And I was like, that's interesting. So that really messed me up. And since then, he had me do it 3 times. And I was like, yeah, no. So each time I was more and more defeated, but I think gratefulness is the cure to everything. That's been my mantra forever. So just letting them know how grateful I was to be there and grateful for this opportunity. And they reached out to me afterward and actually said, you know, we don't think you're right for this role. Duh. But we really appreciated you and we would like to work with you in the future.
Yeah. See, it's all about that. In fact, with us, and I'm sure it's with you, is not everything's dynamite. In fact, our favorite memories of being on stage is eating shit.
Really?
Yeah. It's when a comic bombs, it's probably the most hilarious thing to the comic. And the audience goes with you. They know what's going on. You can't lie to them. But your buddies watching you eat shit is the most. I have better memories of eating it and my friends eating it than my best performance.
Just because, I love that.
Because once you eat it, then you're done. Everything's off. Now you are completely yourself. You've exposed yourself. So now you got, okay, what do I got to lose now?
Yeah.
And that ends up being your best time on stage because you're just loose. You're trying to be yourself and you just let it go. And
I really like comics is they're almost kind of bulletproof. You guys are almost kind of bulletproof because it's all a joke. Everything is for the purpose of making you laugh and bringing you joy. So if you mess up, you know, it's, who cares?
I always think it's about an assassin who's waiting years to get you. You're going to get it. You're going to get shot a couple times. It's, you just don't know what day it is. Yeah. And when you do that, it's like, oh, you got me. I knew it was coming. It was coming. And then you just move on. But I would think with your auditions, you got to, you know, once you get that nervous and you flub up, then you go, okay, just chill and just lean back and just do it.
Absolutely. Yeah. You have to be relaxed and not take yourself too seriously. Again, that's something that I want to get better at every day because I sometimes, especially coming from like a PR background, you know, like everything is should be taken seriously. But that's just not the way to live life. You have to laugh at yourself. You have to acknowledge you're not perfect. You never will be. So that's definitely an opportunity for growth for me.
Yeah, it's not that we don't take it seriously. I mean, we do eat it. We do think about it later.
Yeah.
Oh my God, what was that? I'm embarrassed. I can't do this again. Oh, yeah. My God. I can't show my face out there again. I mean, it definitely hits you, but you have to move on from that.
You really do. You really do.
I think that's back to your quote, win or learn.
What'd you say?
That's back to your quote, win or learn.
Let's do it.
Exactly.
Win or learn.
Any projects we know of coming up? Anything people can tune in? Do you have any social media? I gave a quick search for you and I couldn't find you.
So that is something that is a controversy as well. I actually grew up without social media. I've never had social media. And I know a lot of people in this industry say, well, that's a nail in your coffin. You're not going to get anywhere. But the truth of the matter is I really, really know the harmful effects of social media. And I've known it since 12 years old when I decided not to be a part of it. And I don't forget the generation of social media is everything. People are so addicted to it. They find their validity in it. And it's making people depressed and anxious. I have so many examples of family and friends who are, you know, now clinically diagnosed with anxiety and depression, which was perpetuated by social media. I don't think we want to have that much access to people's lives. You know?
No, I agree. The way it's turned into, yes, we're old enough to know we live lives without it. So when MySpace and Facebook all started coming through, it was great to catch up with relatives, old friends, and now it's turned into this monster of a thing.
Yeah.
And I'm still on it. I like to do the PR on it. And I like keeping up. But when people ask me, did you see what this person said on Facebook or Instagram? I treat that. Those aren't real. I treat it as not real.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's entertaining. I don't take it seriously. And I just know it's a fantasy land for everybody. So
yeah.
To me, it's not real.
Right.
I don't believe everybody on there, you know, and I'll post our thing from the show or I got a haircut. I do it just like that and leave it be. And then I'll see my friends do this dramatic post and you're just like, yeah, okay, take it easy. And then I just move on. But it's not real. I treat it as not real.
Yeah, I think that's a great way to look at it. Unfortunately, a lot of people, especially my age or younger, don't. They think everyone's life is perfect and their life will never compare and everyone's doing something, especially during this time. This has been a really tough time and people turn to social media because they're bored and they feel like their world is falling apart and everyone else's is staying.
Well, you're very fortunate because a lot of people now grew up with that all the way through. So it's peer pressure and I can just see the social pressure that it's bringing on all these young people. And we're fortunate enough, like I said, we've lived great lives without it. So we know that this is, you know, you pick your phone up, go, this is fun. And then you can go like this. Now we're done with that. And do something else. Not every day is an integral part of it.
Right. But that said, I really think YouTube is a great resource and I've been encouraged. Something I've always wanted to do is really just kind of start on YouTube, start posting videos on YouTube of all kinds, you know.
What would you do? What would be like your ideal Adriana YouTube channel? Inspirational bits, skits. We have ours going on and we do so much stuff that we don't know what to do on it.
No idea.
We have this. And we share our shows and all that, but we're just like, we can do more. And then we're like, it's pressure, you know, it's like, okay, now say the line, Adriana. And you go, oh,
exactly. You're so right.
I can't.
YouTube's great because, you know, you have access to people from all countries and their subtitles. So it's easily translated. I remember you mentioning that you guys are like the number one podcast in Pakistan.
Number one comedy podcast in all places, Pakistan.
What?
And we'll take it. We'll definitely take it.
And you said the Philippines as well. So I think that, you know, that's a great example. So, you know, for YouTube, things that I personally think I would be successful at, I love, you know, singing covers of songs. That's something I've always done. It's something I love to do. Maybe I'll have Roy on to do a little...
the numbers are just rolling over now. They're just
could do a duet.
Oh my god, so funny. And you know, there's things that I'm very passionate about, which include, I love the environment. So I have a lot of ways to make things cleaner. Like I don't even want to get into it. It'd be a whole situation, but you know, composting and so many ways.
That alone right there is a niche. And people will go to it. Cover tunes. See, me and Roy, we wouldn't even go there. We're like, we don't even know what we like anymore. We're like, but then I do a project. I do a lot of home projects. So I'll move an electrical plug from here, run the Romex and do all this. And then I see someone do the video on. I'm like, maybe I should have filmed that. And, I don't know my own self talents to put it out on a YouTube channel.
You know what? You have lots of talent. I can already tell you guys are multi-talented and you have great personalities. I think you should try to expand. I think it'd be great, but I love what you're doing. Can I just say, I think it's great.
Wait, we need a social media manager, Roy.
Oh, huh?
That's what I'm thinking. We're just sitting there going, I don't know. I don't know what we should do with this.
Another thing I'm passionate about as well as Sarah, I watched her interview as well. She's so great. I can't wait to finally meet her in person. Oh, yeah. I also am very passionate about health and fitness, mostly health. I'm kind of known as I'm a weird young person in the fact that I don't drink caffeine, I've never had it, and I don't drink alcohol, never had it. So I think, you know, hearing a little bit about ways you can integrate, just be kinder to your body in that way, that's very popular now. And I think I have a lot of insight for my studies
and that criteria right there is your YouTube channel. Yeah. No alcohol, no caffeine. Girl
who doesn't have social media or drink. Click here.
Right. I mean, exactly. That you're a rare bird in this day and age, but you're living a great life. You know what I mean? So that's a good baseline for you to start right there.
I'm also very clean, which is a problem. I just am obsessively clean. So organizing hacks. I had an organizing business in high school. I would go to like people's homes in Oregon and clean up their closets and organize their like kitchens and stuff like that. I love to clean and organize.
There's another video. go to someone's messy closet. We got you hooked up. We got you lined up with projects. We can't do it for ourselves, but we can sure tell someone else how to do it. Well, that was awesome. It was great meeting you, Adriana. I look forward to our project coming up and getting to know everybody and really going forward with everybody. It was a pleasure to meet you and finally have you on the show.
Pleasure to meet you guys. Thank you for the time. And I want to talk to you individually. Maybe we could do what we meet about if you think about some of your lines, because I'm very intrigued.
Would love that.
Yeah. Apparently we have something going on in mid-January. So
yeah.
We'll see.
Yeah. Okay. Well, happy holidays, you guys. Enjoy.
You too. Merry Christmas. Enjoy your family. Enjoy Oregon.
Stay healthy and safe.
Same to you. Bye,
you're
guys.
Breath of fresh air. You're awesome. Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye, guys.
Bye. Well, that was awesome.
Yeah.
No social media, Roy.
Well, I was thinking about it. I was going to bring it up. We're running out of time. But I don't know. Do you remember Angelo Bauer? Big. He was killed by that drunk driver comic. That's the sad part.
Josh, buddy.
He had no social media.
No, and it was really kind of taken. You really kind of needed it back then. That was right. Kind of the de facto get your shit together and set it up on there.
So,
he's still known and beloved and all that and without it. And well, you know, you gave yourself a ban on it. And I look at it and go, I'm just tired of seeing this shit. And really, I do it the post to show and all this. And at that point, then, like I said, once in a while, I have like a relative. You're going, oh, great. Good for you. And I give him a call. But past that, it's just I think it's all bullshit.
Yeah. So thanks again for Adriana Delgado. Film, singing, commercial, music videos, training. She's looking maybe doing YouTube channel, and
we've got her YouTube. We get to work with her lined up. We've got it,
and we get to work with her in a cool movie that we can't talk a lot about what she's doing. That was wonderful, but we got around it.
Is it a movie? Is it not a movie? But we're doing something.
Oh my gosh,
we're doing it. We're doing a no movie.
She's awesome, and the other cool thing about that, as we met Sarah, and now we met Adriana. The cool thing is you can see a little bit that I think is exciting. about the people that are involved in this project.
Right.
A lot of times spiritual, they've got a lot, they connect with it. So because they connect with characters and the storyline and everything to do with it, I can't wait, man. I really can't. It's going to be a lot of fun.
My favorite part is listening to how people eat shit in any career.
Oh yeah. Yeah.
That's my best part. Oh, I ate it. I blew that job so bad. It was, it's on my resume. It was that bad.
And, hey, positive thing.
Yes.
Really positive thing that I see out of this. Number one, two things. One, if we ever get a sitcom, you know, we just call our friend over here.
Right.
Adriana, we've got somebody we need, you know. And number two, I'm going to do some singing on our YouTube channel.
See?
We're going to do some duets.
Morning, John.
Hey, all of you that didn't get enough of me during karaoke breaks on our station. Right
the
now,
surface that is just the surface of it. That is the Roy Brewster bubbling. You are the pudding. You're at pudding skin right now.
Right? I'm pudding skin.
You're at pudding skin right now. We're breaking through. We're breaking through your pudding skin.
And I tell you all the time, people listen, they laugh at me. Look right here. There's somebody with talent that just was on our show who can sing, who knows these things, and who she choose? This guy. Come on, we're gonna do some singing. Oh my God.
Yeah, I love hearing how we have untapped talent.
Yeah, I tap away. I see none of it.
Keep a knocking.
Keep a knocking. Maybe it'll come loose.
One of these bastards will open the door. Are you talking to me?
Oh my God!
Are you talking to me? I got. No, I didn't. I didn't check my phone obviously during the Christmas play yesterday. But after the show, I had a text from our buddy Dennis live from the guard shack.
Oh,
and I wish I'd seen it. He says expecting a little Hey Willie during this.
Oh,
and of course, it would have been perfect. I think I've done it every play, but I was a little tied up there, Dennis. But a little Hey Willie, throw right there. Plus, I didn't have a character, so what do you do?
Well, you know what I did notice?
What's that?
This play or yesterday, as opposed to the other ones, it didn't really get crazy off the rails at any point.
No, no, we really tried to stay right on there.
I think I dropped an F-bomb where it wasn't blunt, but it felt good. But other than that, no.
You did a freestyle.
You're fucking kids. I don't even know why it came out. But it wasn't, sometimes it gets out there, and I think it was because we didn't have Eric.
the lovely and talented Eric Escobar, yes.
Yeah. And the other one, we didn't have Gus. And Gus is a dirty bastard.
That's I tell you what, that happened. SOB. We'll definitely have to throw him in there just so we can see if he's available next year. Mm. See if he is available. Check everyone's avail, Roy. Anybody wants to be in our Christmas play next year, if you can send your avails, that'd be great.
You guys better get on it now, because if we start playing these, you know, the people, real actors that we're talking to now, you know, we're going to blow you off in a minute. Friends or not. We don't have time for you.
Like who? I know, the only people I'm going to know at that point is you and my mama.
Right.
The rest of you, you're going to have to make an appointment with our social media manager.
Right.
And see if my people can squeeze in an appointment with your people.
Right. Man. So, you know, you can put your name on a list of some kind, just so we'll remember who you are, because by the time we get so big, we won't remember. It won't really matter to us.
Show up at our office and see if you're on the invite list. No, I don't. I don't see you. You're not.
And you know what? Here's okay though. We won't remember you, but you can remember us. So if you're ever in a party, you can say, "Hey, I remember back in the day I went with that guy." We won't sue you or do anything like that. You can use those stories as long as they're in good light, but don't expect to come over to the house.
That might be the fairest title, everything, the fairest slogan right there. You can remember us. So that's the important part. You remember us. Look at your mom. She said, "Excuse me." See, I said I remember two people, my mom and you. So you know, you're
right.
You better be nice to your mom until those packages get shipped back to you.
No, most families in there too. Like I say, most. Yeah, the people that mean something to you, not the family member that you haven't heard from in 9 years, and they're like, when we were kids and we, you know, we did this stupid thing together, and you're like, no, I don't.
My second cousin.
Where have you been?
My second cousin Jennifer, who listens to the show in Arizona. Sorry, babe.
Second cousin, you get cut off right there.
Sorry, Jen. It may happen. It may have to happen this way.
It's like, you know, parents, you know, mom, and then all of a sudden you're like cousin, and then second cousin. That's it.
Once we get like one little break, we should totally go total dick on it, just like that. Just on the most littlest thing we get. Maybe after this movie's done and out, then we just be like a dick for a day.
Okay.
Don't know anybody. Take no calls. Just live that life for a day.
And that'd be different for me, how?
So what's new?
Hey, you want some tip? Want a couple tips to go that way? I'll show you. Remember, I'm the guy driving down the road where somebody I knew was calling me, and I looked at it, and they were watching me on the phone. I went, fuck that, and threw the phone on the thing. And then I looked over and saw him on the phone going,
Everybody saw you mouth, what's this asshole want?
Hold on, threw the phone down.
Fuck this guy.
Oops.
Hilarious.
But see, I'm not completely dickish, because if that was the case, if he looked at me with the phone like that, I would have went, whatever, flipped him off. But right. I didn't. I felt bad at that point.
Sure.
So that means I have a little bit of heart, kind of like the Grinch, that little part down there. It's good.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And before cell phones were everywhere, I remember running errands at work, and then I get to work and I get a phone call, and it's my buddy Tim. He goes, dude, I was at the freeway right next to you. You didn't look over. And then you go, oh shit, I feel bad. But then now you have your cell phone just like you did. You're like, I didn't feel like talking to you. So how do I translate that to, Bill, I thought it was Tim. Yeah, no, I saw you, son of a bitch.
Yeah.
I saw you throw the phone. I saw you look at my name, hit the thumb, and threw the phone. One of the apps I want to come up with is an app that records the last 3 seconds after you hang up.
Oh, yeah.
The last 3 seconds. Anybody who talks to anybody on the phone, you blah, 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 blah. You hang up the phone, click. Jesus Christ. You know, everyone has a comment. Or, you know, get off the phone, it's a great phone call. You get up there going, holy shit, that was awesome. You know what I mean? Just that 3 seconds after you hang up. Are you kidding me?
Yeah.
That kind of thing. Are you kidding me?
I don't want anyone else to have that app for me.
No, we use it for us, just us. I'll make it just for me and you.
It's going to be a money maker. It's going to be good for us to have.
We're going to lose money just for this self-entertainment.
Right?
Yeah.
Mm. Wow.
Yeah, you talk to your girlfriend on the phone, you talk to your boss at work, get on the phone, get off there going, Jesus, what an asshole. I mean, everyone has something, that inner voice.
Right?
Right, that inner thing. Oh, my God, I love her. Oh, man, that was, oh. And then you're like, fuck, every goddamn time. Those 3 seconds post-conversation, inner thoughts.
Every goddamn time. Every time. Well, I don't know.
Good or bad, I'll hang up the phone with you or John. I go, this fucking guy.
Yeah, that's right.
that's pretty much universal blanket right there.
Yeah, I don't have a problem with that.
It's like this fucking guy or that fucking guy. Yeah, universal. One sentence. It's all you need.
Hey, today is Ann and Samantha Day. I just had to.
Ann and Samantha Day. Who? What? And where is that?
What?
What is Ann and Samantha Day, Roy?
Well, it's summer and winter solstices, also June 20th. But I wasn't aware of this day. I'm a little shocked.
Hmm.
I don't know what it is. It is the Global Orgasm Day.
Well, if we must. Get on that.
And it's funny. It says, if I go to the page, it says the annual Global Orgasm Day for World Peace. And right below it, it says, come together. No shit.
There's your slogan right there. What was that other one? Would you say Anne and who?
Anne and Sarah? Samantha. Anne and Samantha Day.
Anne and Samantha Day.
Yeah.
I want to look that up. My curiosity. Here we go. Anne and Samantha Day. National Day Calendar. Let's see what here is. Day of summer and winter. So Anne Frank and Samantha Smith.
Okay, yeah, can't make fun of that.
No. When you said Anne Frank, I'm out. It's like, okay, we're good. Thank you.
National Flashlight Day, though.
Yeah, baby.
And you know why?
Why?
Because it's the shortest day of the year for sunlight.
Oh, okay.
See, kind of cool. This is Jimmy, his shorts day. Jimmy loved the shorts.
Almost every day.
Yeah.
I'm growing up a little bit. I've been wearing the long pants since it started cooling down.
So I don't know if you know, but winter solstice starts today at 10:59 a.m.
Okay.
Eastern time. So we're already in winter solstice. Now,
see, you know I don't like 90% of these days, but I'll tell you what, when they make sense.
Yeah.
National Flashlight Day on winter solstice.
Yeah.
That's some thinking.
And this is Jimmy's day. Not so much the last couple of years, but today is humbug day.
Okay. You know, and I think that's a good spaced humbug. Because you're coming into it hard. I mean, you're coming into it soft after Thanksgiving. You're like, okay, Christmas, here we go. Okay, bullshit. Okay, I got my stuff. And then you just get right to this is the fed up part of the holidays. You know, 3-4 days before Christmas, you're like, I can't find the wrapping paper. My shipment didn't show up. And then after that, you're into acceptance. So I will take that day I'll give it validity.
All right. Well, that's all the days I got for you.
Oh, that's a good.
Unless we got a good week that we'd look at, but I don't know. It's kind of 14th to 28th is I don't know. Nothing good.
Christmas is kind of overshadowing those days.
Yeah, Christmas got everyone, you know, worrying about other things than days.
Christmas stealing the thunder.
Right. This would be a good time. You know what it'd be for? Because no one else wants them. I think this would be the great time for the Roy and Jimmy Day, right around this time of year.
You know what, Roy? Because you know what it is? It's about giving. We are about giving.
Supposed to have snow Christmas Eve and Christmas Day.
Well, look at you living that picturesque winter Christmas life there, Drew. No, it's a good share. It's a good share. Yeah, see, sure. Drew is a comic. He knows when we needed some material. He knew when to feed us a little something. Hey, how about your car? Oh, yeah, my car's a piece of shit. That's a good comic friend right there.
What else am I here to talk about?
It's like him holding. He held up the comic cue card for us right there.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah. And next.
You think we're running out of steam there, Drew? Is that what you're trying to tell us?
I think for today's show, Drew Yerkes has earned an associate producer's credit. Thank you very much. Good job, buddy. Good job.
Right. Never had a white Christmas.
You're welcome for the material.
Right. Need something a little deeper. We ran out of it. We ran on it.
I have been on stage many times where I just went total blank, and I look at Roy, what's that thing I do?
That's happened.
Roy's in the back, you know. What about the Kardashians? Oh, my God. Here we go. And then you just start rolling.
Are ready to rock.
Associate producer today, Drew Yerkes, everybody. Give it up for Drew. Oh, my
God. I don't want to say it because it's like asking for something that you wish someone would give you. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Because I've been waiting all day for you, Jimmy. All day. And this is the reason, I've been waiting because I'm ready to go because I'm always caught off guard, but I've had it here the whole time. And today of all days, nothing.
Of course. Line.
It's just waiting.
This is the day we went off book and it didn't work out.
It's sitting here.
That our acting language, we're going off book.
I guess.
I hope everyone's enjoying the actors we got coming in through. It's obviously for the project we got coming up, and we got a slew of them lined up. So we'll definitely have one pretty much every Monday.
In case you weren't sure, a slew is a lot.
A slew, a plethora.
Well, just in a few weeks, we're going to be
table reading.
Yeah, and we're going to be...
See, we can talk about
getting real things going on.
Yeah, we can talk about it. Adriana, we couldn't, but we kind of didn't. We mostly didn't. We did not enjoy talking about the non-movie.
Yeah, it was kind of tough.
It wasn't tough at all. She was a natural.
Yeah, she was fine. It was funny, Drew. She laughed when we said it. It's like, Yeah, I know.
Drew Yerkes, she pulled us through. She helped us out. She made it happen. Look at that, Roy. Do you see what time it is?
Yeah, I wonder what time it is, Jimmy.
It is 8:52. I think we're going to shut this baby down.
I wonder what time it is.
I wonder what time it is. 8:52.
Just so you know, it's 10 days, 255 hours, 15,307 minutes, 9,184,058 seconds.
I am going to stop. You are the ultimate pro. What the hell? The hell thinking?
That's all we need. It's over. Shut it down. Let him know.
No. You got me this time. I'm always getting you, but you got me this time. Roy Brewster, congratulations. Let it happen. Damn it.
You know, we wonder a lot. I mean, the year has flown by. We said it was going to happen. We told you here on the show. But you know, it is only 10 days away from...
...2021.
There you go. Something looked weird right here. It's Friday the 1st, actually, a week from this Friday. So it's 255 hours, 15,308 minutes. Oh, my God. 918,402 seconds, which means we will turn to 2021 in 10 days, 15 hours, 6 minutes, and 34 seconds.
Yes.
Oh. All right, I feel better now.
You son of a bitch. You got me.
I got to do it again? Oh, no.
No. You got me, buddy. God. Well done. Oh, my God. I don't know what you're doing. That is a true pro right there. True goddamn pro. Stop with the math, Roy. I have a headache. Oh, no. Wait till January starts on this countdown,
oh,
Drew.
Oh, God.
The numbers are phenomenally... Well, it's back up. They're huge.
Back that thing up.
Back that thing up. This shit is getting huge.
It's a quote.
I don't think I really wanted to say that with Drew as the subject.
Yeah.
All right, everyone, have a great day. Thanks for listening. Thanks, Adriana, for entertaining us. Great interview there. Don't look for her. She's not there.
No. But you can, if you want to get to her and you got stuff for her, let us know. We'll get you to her.
And you know what, Roy? We are the only ones she's on a social media with.
Ah, get some of that.
You can't find her except us. We are giving her to you.
We will be your conduit.
Okay, be sure to take a huge bottle of Tylenol close by Jack Daniels. See, there you go. Jack and Tylenol.
Yep.
It handles everything, Drew. All right, everyone. Thanks again for listening. Thanks for watching yesterday. We're back here tomorrow morning, 7 to 9, YouTube Live, Facebook Live. We'll have Sean Williams and Donna Main with us. So definitely come on back.
Birthdays, countdowns, fun, and a Christmas game. And I may be shirtless.
But we're definitely going to be bottomless.
We'll talk to you then. Love you all. Hit them, baby.
Hit them, baby.